The police minister says he wouldn't care if speed cameras didn't produce any revenue, as it'd mean they were saving lives. The government's launched a new ad crediting cameras for lowering the road toll.
To drive home the message that speed cameras do slow motorists down, the government spent $2.5 million on a new campaign.
They don't see that cameras have helped cut our road toll by a third, saving thousands of lives.
I would be the happiest guy in the state of Victoria if we did not make a cracker out of these things.
The minister says recent issues with point-to-point cameras on the Hume Freeway prove they work. During a 60-day testing phase, when drivers thought the cameras were still switched off, more than 19,000 were caught speeding but not fined. In the next 60 days, when motorists were told the cameras were fully operational, the number nabbed fell to just over 9,000.
These are a deterrent to people who are otherwise going to speed.
Mother of three, Wendy Eccles, has spent the past 20 years in a wheelchair after a driver didn't stop at an intersection. She's a strong supporter of this latest campaign.
Would they still make that decision if they knew just around the corner they were going to, you know, hit somebody, put them in a wheelchair for the rest of their life?
Nevertheless, a string of problems with speed cameras has undermined confidence in the technology.
We have in place now a system which is as close to guaranteeing that cannot happen as you can conceivably get.
Meanwhile, almost 7,000 drivers incorrectly fined at intersections with faulty lights should get their money back within a fortnight. Nicole Strawn, 10 News.